A loud raging debate over cryptocurrency in Parliament.
I would request the Honourable Member to kindly wait to see what is going in the bill.
Thank you. Mananiya Neeraj Shekhar ji.
Sir, जैसा कि सब लोग कह रहे हैं कि बिल आने वाला है, लेकिन बिल आने से पहले, क्योंकि एक क्रिप्टोकरेंसी है बिटकॉइन, जो शुरू हुई थी $1 से, आज $60,000 उसका मूल्य है, तो इससे मैं मानता हूं कि एक अनुमान जो लगाया गया भारत देश में कि करोड़ों लोगों ने इसमें निवेश किया है, इसमें पैसा अपना लगाया है और लाखों करोड़ रुपए उसमें चले गए हैं, क्या भारत सरकार उन लोगों को बताने की कोशिश कर रही है कि ये अभी सुरक्षित नहीं है, ऐसा पैसा लगा रहे हैं जो आगे उनका नुकसान हो सकता है? हमारा वित्त मंत्रालय इसमें कुछ, जब तक बिल नहीं आता तब तक समझाने की कोशिश कर सकता है ऐसे पैसों में निवेश ना करें, तो इसमें कुछ कर रहे हैं वित्त मंत्रालय?
Sir, Honourable Member Neeraj Shekhar ji and also for that matter the member from Odisha, Amar Patnaik ji, had both raised this question. Yes, the bill will come, all right. But till then, definitely attempts, and I'm sure also economist Narin Jadhav ji also mentioned that, through the SEBI, through the RBI and through once, I think, Government of India, there have been statements issued and also fairly awareness building attempt has been made to say that this is a risky area and people who are going in there, be conscious as to what you're doing, and also said that this is an area yet not in complete regulatory framework. So I'm sure the House remembers that when nearly 2 years ago, 2.5 years ago, when Reserve Bank of India attempted to regulate this, it was through the Supreme Court. The matter was highlighted that in the absence of a clear-cut policy, regulation by RBI also may not be proper. So that drove the attempt to have a group, and then the inter-ministerial group worked into it, and then the policy came up, and policy was not issued out, but we are now bringing a bill and so on. So time has lapsed. In the meanwhile, it has also proliferated. At the same time, awareness issue or alert, if I can use the word, has been issued so that people are fairly cautioned that this may be a high risk area to go in. That much has been done. Maybe more can be done on that area. I concede for Honourable Member Neeraj Shekhar's concern, but that's the point. So we are doing those little things, but then the bill is what is being keenly looked for.
Thank you, ma'am. Second supplementary, Mananiya Neeraj ji.
इसी से सभापति जी, इसी से जुड़ा हुआ है दूसरा प्रश्न भी. अभी किसी ने शायद पहले ही बोला कि कहीं आप किसी वेबसाइट पर जाइए, इंटरनेट खोलिए, तो इसके एडवर्टाइजमेंट बहुत आ रहे हैं और हमारे नौजवान साथी उसमें पैसा लगा रहे हैं, तो क्या भारत सरकार ऐसा कर रही है, इन जो एडवर्टाइजमेंट आ रहे हैं इनको बंद करने का कोई उपाय हो सकता है? तब तक
बंद करने का उपाय अभी तक कुछ नहीं है, मगर जरूर कॉशन देने का युवाओं को इस विषय में, जो रिस्क है उस विषय में ध्यान दिलाने के लिए कदम उठा रहे हैं सरकार के द्वारा, सेबी के द्वारा, आरबीआई के द्वारा. जैसे मैंने कहा, इससे और अधिक मात्रा में वो कर सकते हैं, मगर अब हम इस कगार पर आ गए हैं कि हमारे बिल जल्दी आने वाला
है. धन्यवाद. मनीष सुजीत कुमार जी.
थैंक यू सर. Sir, with the proliferation of crypto exchanges and the explosion of crypto transactions, it is inevitable that scams, frauds, and as Honorable Member Narendra Jadhav ji has observed, money laundering also is going to happen in a massive way. I suspect, sir, anti-national forces might also try to use these platforms to hurt the Indian economy and possibly destabilize the Indian economy. So is the government aware of any such move by anti-national forces, and if yes, what is it planning to do? Thank you.
Sir, the risk that this can lead to some kind of illegal transfers to not so desirable activities are matters which are in the regular course also being monitored by institutions, by enforcement authorities and so on, and the Ministry of Finance benefits from inputs from them. So I would only tell the member that these are matters which are definitely being discussed at various levels.
Thank you. Mananiya Sushil Kumar Modi ji.
Mananiya Upasabhapati Mahoday, abhi madam ne advertisements ke bare mein kaha. I want to ask madam in the last 4 months, there are flurry of misleading ad on TV, print media, and the social media, and they are promising heaven to the investors. And during this World Cup 2020, more than 50 crore was spent by the crypto exchange companies. So, I want to know, is there any plan to ban such advertisements? Because जो स्टेटमेंट्स आए हैं आरबीआई के, वो किसी ने पढ़ा नहीं, केवल अंग्रेजी के अखबार में स्टेटमेंट्स आ गए. सो आर यू गोइंग टू इंसर्ट सम एडवर्टीजमेंट्स प्रोमिनेंट इन ऑल द रीजनल एंड हिंदी एंड इंग्लिश न्यूज़पेपर्स, नंबर वन. नंबर टू, दैट बिकॉज दीज एड्स आर विदाउट एनी डिस्क्लेमर, सो आर यू गोइंग टू, इज गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया थिंकिंग ऑफ बैनिंग सच एडवर्टीजमेंट्स विच आर मिसलीडिंग और जिसके कारण लोगों का करोड़ों रुपया नुकसान हो सकता है? इसलिए मेरा स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चन है कि इज गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया कॉन्टेम्पलेटिंग टू बैन सच misleading advertisements till the bill comes to this house, because nobody knows this bill will come or not come. Last time also it was mentioned in the bulletin, but it was but it could not come into the house. So, isliye ban karne ke bare mein mera aagrah hai ki kya sarkar vichar karegi ban karne ke bare mein.
Sujhav.
Sir, two things. Last time also there was a bill mentioned and it didn't happen. I just want to remind honorable member, yes, last time there was a bill proposed, but subsequently, because there were other dimensions which in the real time we thought it was important to bring into the bill, that bill had been reworked, and in a way the bill which is coming now is a new bill, but never mind, the work done on that have all been taken on board here. So intent was either we improve that bill or come with a bill which is going to be far more recent. So that intent of getting that bill at that time was there, genuine intent. And now we are coming up with a new bill, so it's not as if the last time we just put it there, didn't want to come with one, so leading to a suspicion that this time also we are putting a bill, we may not come up with one. No, let me be clear on that, that the earlier attempt was definitely to come up with a bill, which the House can consider. But later, because rapidly a lot of things had to come into play, we had started working on a new bill, and this is the bill which is now being proposed. And this bill is, once the Cabinet clears it, it will come here into the House. That is one thing. And second, about the misleading advertisements and about are we banning them, I want to inform the Honourable Member, who's been a Finance Minister earlier in Bihar, I've also been in very influential and guiding positions in the GST Council, whose advice all of us have benefited from. So I value his question. There are, with the Advertisement Standards Council of India, the ASCI, which governs all advertisements, their guidelines are being studied, and the regulations that they have are all being looked into, so that we can take, if necessary, some kind of a position or a decision to say how we are going to handle this. I can inform the Honourable Member that.
Thank you. Second supplementary.
Sir, my question number two was there, whether the government is seeking to make a separate legal framework for NFT. It has not been answered in this question, in this answer. So I would like, because I have asked that there should be a separate legal framework for NFT. It should not be a part of Cryptocurrency Act. So is government thinking of a legal separate framework, legal framework for NFT? And number two, because you have answered in question number four in D, so I would like to know how many people have paid income tax on cryptocurrencies, and how much tax has been collected. Can the minister tell the House how many people have paid income tax on cryptocurrency, income from the cryptocurrency, and how much tax has been collected?
Thank you.
So I don't have the ready information on how much tax has been collected on cryptocurrency or how much has been paid on it. And as regards NFT, the non-fungible ones, Honourable Member desires having a separate legal framework. At this moment, I may not be able to say whether I will give a separate framework or not, but certainly, as I said, all these matters are being discussed.
Thank you. Question number 20, Dr. V. Sudarshan, not present. Mani Mantri ji. No supplementary. Mani V. Yes, I ready.
Sir, the National Institute of Public Finance and Policy has recommended that the four key slab rate system of 5%, 12%, 18% and 28% can smoothly be replaced by three-tier slab system of 8, 15 and 30% without causing any loss of revenue to the exchequer. I would like to know from the Honorable Finance Minister what steps are being taken, whether such proposal is being accepted and whether it is advisable to accept the such proposal.